Baik, we discuss about life, and now we go to chapter 12.2, how shadows form. I think when we have KBS, maybe yesterday, I was give you explanation about shadows and image, because shadow and image is different. Okay. I think most of you understand about shadows form. Yeah, when light strikes an object, different things can happen. It depends on the material the object is made of. Jadi, kalau ada cahaya mengenai sebuah objek, ya tergantung ya. The light may pass straight through the object. We say that it has been transmitted. The material is transparent. Jadi kalau transparan itu transmitted, diteruskan. And then the light may be absorbed by the object. The material is opaque, ya, opaque. Jadi opaque atau ya diabsorb, ya, diserap. And then the light may bounce off the object. We say that it has been reflected, ya, jadi mengkilap, ya, mengkilap itu reflected, akan mantul, bounce itu mantul, ya, mantul, bukan mantap betul, tapi memantulkan atau reflected, mantul, ya. Oke. Sometimes two of these things can happen, or all three. Jadi bisa jadi ketiga-tiganya atau dua, ya. For example, glass transmits light, but it may also reflect some of it. Jadi bahan itu kadang nggak hanya absorb doang atau reflected aja, tapi dua-duanya. Contohnya kaca itu kan bisa sebagian itu reflected, sebagian absorb atau diserap, ya. Oke. Okay. Saya kira Sedo sudah oke, ya. Oke, okay, now Fahri. Assalamualaikum, Fahri.
Ya, salam.
Fahri, question number one, please.
The pencil as a shadow. Is the pencil opaque or transparent?
Kurang keras.
The pencil has a shadow. Is the pencil opaque or transparent?
Okay. The answer is opaque. Ya, opaque. Ya. Kalau transparan kan nggak bisa ada shadow, ya. Yeah. Oke, okay. Thank you. Now Atta, assalamualaikum Atta. Atta Putri, assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Oke, okay, number two please.
A shiny object reflect light. Will a shiny object make a shadow when light shines on it? Explain your answer.
So? Jadi gimana? What the answer? Halo? Mbak Atta?
Yeah.
A shiny object reflects light. Mbak Atta, will a shiny object make a shadow when light shines on it?
No.
Yeah.
No, it doesn't make a shadow.
Oh, jadi kalau shiny object, insya Allah juga ada shadow-nya, ya. Wait, ya. My speaker is not good. Okay. Wait. Oke, gimana Mbak Ata? Mbak Ata.
Iya, Pak.
Ya, jadi gimana? Akan ada shadow nggak kalau shiny object itu?
Ada.
Ada objeknya ya. Not only reflect the light, but also make a shadow ya. The shadow is form ya. Terjadi bayangan. Jadi apa namanya shiny object itu dia akan membantu dan juga bisa jadi akan membuat shadows. Okay, thank you. Okay, we go to the next. Rays of light. Kalila, would you like to read the text? Rays of light.
Rays of light. When we want to understand light, we often draw diagrams with straight line showing the path of the light rays. To understand where the tree's shadow will fall, we need to draw lots of rays of light all coming from the sun. Then we can see which ray are blocked up by the tree. This will show us where the tree shadow will be.
Okay, thank you. Wah, ini sudah lemes semua ini yang pada puasanya. When we want to understand light, we often draw diagrams with straight lines showing the path of the light rays. Jadi ketika kita belajar untuk memahami cahaya, kita perlu garis-garis lurus ya, seperti yang ada di gambar the three blocks some of the sun's rays ya. To understand where the tree's shadow will fall, we need to draw lots of rays of light. Jadi garis-garis ini sebagai rays of light-nya ya, all coming from the sun ya, semuanya dari matahari. Then we can see which rays are blocked by the tree. This will show us where the tree's shadow will be. Jadi dengan begitu, dengan ini ya, ini udah oke. Annotate-nya agak oke. Nah ini garis-garisnya ini ya. Nah kemudian yang tidak tertembus ini kan ini ya, bloknya di sini dan di sini adalah shadow-nya yang tidak tertembus oleh the rays of lights. Yeah. Mbak Kalila, continue with question number 3, please. Mbak Kalila, question 3.
Yeah. Explain why we draw straight lines to show rays of light.
Gimana?
Because light comes in a straight line.
Okay, thank you. Abhishek, your answer, yeah. Explain why we draw straight lines to show rays of light. Yeah, kalau dengan rays of light itu, kemudian kita kan tahu tuh cahaya itu berjalannya seperti apa, mengenai objeknya bagaimana, terus kemudian bagian mana dari objek itu yang kemudian menimbulkan area yang tidak bisa tertembus cahaya dan sudah tak bunderi merah, tak kasih tanda yang merah ini, ellipse ya. Okay, thank you Mbak Kalila. We go to the next students. Mbak Aisyah, assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Mbak, please number 4, Mbak.
Look again at the diagram of the tree and its shadow. Later in the day, the sun will move around so that it is shining from the top right-hand corner of the diagram. We draw the diagram with the sun rays coming from the top right and work out where the tree's shadow will be.
Okay, actually you have to draw, yeah, but We just discussed about this question. Yeah, look again at the diagram of the tree and its shadows. Jadi kita disuruh melihat lagi, ya. Kita disuruh lihat lagi apa namanya gambar ini. Later in the day, ya. Jadi beberapa waktu kemudian, ya, the sun will move round. Ya, matahari itu kan akan bergerak, ya. Anggap aja ini dari mana, ya, dari timur yang ini. Ya. Will move around so that it is shining from the top right hand. Jadi shining from the top right hand, berarti yang samping sana, ya. Corner of the diagram, redraw the diagram with the sun's rays coming from the top right and work out where the tree shadow will be. Jadi kita disuruh ini apa namanya mengubah arah matahari. Kalau arah mataharinya diubah, sinarnya matahari diubah, maka rays of light also will be changed, ya. Will change with different direction. Jadi kemudian kalau kita ubah posisi mataharinya karena posisi itu dipengaruhi oleh waktu, maka the rays of light also change. Jadi apa namanya? Cahaya matahari itu yang kita simbolkan dengan garis-garis ini akan berubah dan kita harus gambar lagi. Sebenarnya cuma gitu aja, ya. Ya, yeah, most of the question of Cambridge book or Cambridge course book and also workbook, I think so easy for us, but we have to understand. Kita harus mengetahui, memahami what is the question, what is the instruction, ya, yeah, what they want from us to answer, ya. Jadi kemarin itu waktu yang reinforcement yang terakhir itu tak lihat pertanyaan Ustaz Yubi itu gampang-gampang aja sebenarnya. Cuman karena mungkin nggak paham, ya. Nggak paham dengan apa namanya pertanyaan, kemudian ada yang menjawab dari pertanyaan itu jawaban yang sebenarnya tidak dibutuhkan, ya. Some the students answer with unnecessary answer, ya. Sebenarnya jawabannya yang dibutuhkan dijawabkan di situ, gitu. Oke, okay. We go to the next shadows like this, ya, shadows, ya. Now we go to 12.3. Someone Kin nanti, assalamualaikum. Kin nanti. Kin nanti. Halo. Kin nanti, assalamualaikum.
Salam.
Okay, Kim, would you like to help me read how reflections form from top to what itu sampai mana itu sampai mirror without being scatter?
Okay. When you look in a mirror, you see a clear reflection of yourself. The picture you see in a mirror is called an image. Bouncing like mirror reflect light. White paper reflects light. Why do we see a clear image in a mirror but not in a sheet of paper? A sheet of paper has a rough surface. When rays of light strike the paper, they are scattered in all directions. A mirror has a very flat, smooth surface. Rise of like bones of a mirror without being scattered.
Oke. Okay. Ini nanti jangan dimatikan mic-nya, ya. Oke. Okay. Bagi nanti.
Iya.
Yeah. Ada ngaji, ya? Kita mau sholat.
Enggak, adik belajar azan.
Oke, okay, it's okay. Ini nanti why mirror better than paper for reflection. Kenapa cermin itu lebih baik dalam apa pemantulannya daripada kertas? Why?
Gak tahu, Pak.
Itu sudah kamu baca. Why do we see a clear image in a mirror, but not in a sheet of paper? Nah itu, a sheet of paper has a rough surface. Jadi kalau paper itu permukaannya agak kasar, itu yang membuat not good. When rays of light strike the paper, they are scattered in all directions. Jadi ketika ada rays of lights, ya cahaya yang strike, yang mengenai dari paper itu, kemudian dia scatter in all direction. Jadi dia ada kayak pembauran gitu ini. Jadi pemantulannya gak karu-karuan, ya sehingga not good for reflection. I mean, if there is an object in front of the paper, cannot reflect it perfectly. Jadi nggak bisa di cannot be reflected perfectly. Jadi nggak bisa di ini dipantulkan dengan baik sehingga buram. A mirror has a very flat, smooth surface. Kalau mirror itu cermin itu kan very flat, sangat datar ya. Kemudian smooth surface, permukaannya itu smooth ya. Rays of light bounce off a mirror without being scattered. Jadi cahaya itu akan bounce itu memantul ya. Tidak ada bounce off ya. Enggak karu-karuan itu. Karena tidak ada scatter ya. Karena permukaannya adalah flat, very flat. Thank you Kinanti.
Iya, Dad.
Okay, we go to the next case. Predicting the path of light. It's very good ini. Very asik ini. Okay. Mbak Silva, assalamualaikum.
Waalaikumsalam.
Mbak Silva, I need you to read this text, please.
If you shine a ray of light at a mirror, it reflects off the mirror. The law of reflection tells us about the direction in which the ray is reflected. The diagram on the right shows this. Here is how to understand this diagram. The mirror is represented by a straight line. The shading shows the back of the mirror. The ray of light coming in is called the incident light. The ray of light going out is the reflected ray. To predict the direction of the reflected ray, we need to draw the normal to the surface of the mirror. The normal is a straight line drawn at right angles, 90 degrees to the mirror at the point where the ray is reflected. The law of reflection of light states that the two angles marked in the diagram are equal, but that each of the angle is measured from the normal to the ray, not from the ray to the mirror.
Okay, thank you so much, Silva. Predicting the path of light. Ustaz juga akan directly to the diagram, ya. Yeah? Okay, now here. This is a mirror, ya. Yeah? Ini mirror, ya. Yeah? Yang ini adalah bagian belakangnya. Yang ini, ya. Yeah? Based on this one. The mirror is represented by a straight line. The setting shows the back of the mirror. Jadi cermin di sini direpresentasikan atau diwakili oleh garis lurus ini, ya. The setting shows the back of the mirror. Yang ini back of the mirror, ya. Settingnya ini. And then incident ray is sinar datang, ya. Ada sinar datang, and then reflected ray adalah sinar pantul. So it must be two angle because there are incident ray and deflected ray. So automatically there is angle of incidence. Yeah, there is angle of incidence atau sudut sinar datang, and then angle of reflection atau sudut pantul. Yeah, based on this explanation or the description here, that the angle of incident ray and the angle of reflection is the same, yeah, because this is a flat mirror, yeah, flat mirror, and so smooth, there is no raw, there is no scatter, yeah. Jadi langsung ketika ada sinar datang langsung dipantulkan dengan with same angle, the angle of the incidence and the angle of reflection is the same, yeah. Itu adalah law of reflection. Law of reflection, yeah. Law of reflection is angle of incident equal with angle of reflection. Jadi cuman gitu aja ya. Oke. Okay, until here, there are some questions. There are any questions? Okay, we continue. How light bends? Sekarang usah juga ke siapa ya? Bata.
Yeah.
Read the text, please.
The photograph show a pencil standing in a beaker of water. The pencil looks as if it's broken at the point where it enters the water. You may have noticed others change a path when looking through water or glass. A river or pool may look shallower than it really is, for example.
Then, continue.
Lanjut yang.
Yes.
Material.
Yeah.
Water and glass are transparent material. Light can pass through them, but something happens when light enters or leaves such a material. We need to follow the path of a ray to see what happens. The photograph shows how a ray of light bends when it enters a glass block. It bends again when it leaves the block. The change of direction of a light ray when it enters or leaves a transparent material is called refraction.
Okay. How light bends? Jadi bagaimana cahaya itu kok bisa membuat apa ya? Bend itu apa sih? Bengkok ya? Halo, anyone? Bengkok atau membengkok ya? The photograph shows a pencil standing in a beaker of water. Jadi ini seorang fotografer taruh pensil dalam beaker ya, beaker of water. The pencil looks as if it is broken at the point where it enters the water. Jadi bagian yang perbatasan antara udara dengan air itu kemudian kelihatan broken, rusak ya. Patah. You may have noticed a strange effect when looking through water or glass. A river or pool may look shallower than it really is, for example. Jadi itu ya efek pada water atau glass itu ya. Transparent materials, water and glass are transparent materials. Kita tahu ya, air dan glass itu transparan. Tadi sudah ada tiga, ada transparan, ada opaque, sama ada yang apa tadi ya, shiny apa reflected ya, yang memantulkan tadi. Sorry, saya Ustaz lupa. Oke. Okay. Water and glass are transparent materials. Light can pass through them. Cahaya bisa melewatinya, melewati water and glass ya. But something happens when light enters or leaves such a materials. Jadi terjadi sesuatu ketika cahaya itu memasuki atau meninggalkan sebuah material atau sebuah materi. materi yang berbeda tentunya. In this case, water and air. Jadi pada kasus ini adalah air dan udara. Ya. We need to follow the path of a ray to see what happened. Jadi kita membutuhkan untuk melihat path of ray. Jadi bagian-bagian sinar itu untuk mengetahui apa yang terjadi. The photograph shows how a ray of light bends when it enters a glass block. Jadi fotografernya itu menunjukkan bagaimana ray of light, ya, cahaya itu bends, ya, when it enters a glass block. Jadi terlihat apa namanya bend, ada yang bengkok, ada yang bend itu kadang bisa diartikan tikungan, ya, kita anggapkan bengkok gitu aja, ya. The change of direction of a light ray when it enters or leaves a transparent material is called refraction. Nah, ini kemarin yang KBS sudah ngerti refraction and reflection. Refraction is pembiasan. Jadi ini pensil kelihatan patah, broken because of refraction. Refraction, refraction itu pembiasan. The refraction based on the materials that interact each other, ya. Jadi apa namanya? Ya, tergantung bahannya, ya, refraction itu. Kalau bahannya sangat-sangat ekstrim berbeda, maka akan terjadi pembiasan yang sangat ekstrim juga, gitu. Refraction. Oke. Okay. Oke, okay, we have discussed about refraction, and then look at the photograph of the ray of light traveling through the glass block. Where does the ray bend? What path does it follow inside the glass block? Nah, ini kalau where does the ray bend itu, ya, diantaranya, ya, ketika perbatasan itu. What path does it follow inside the glass block? Bagian mana yang mengikuti inside the glass block? Ya, kalau yang atas ngikuti udara, ya, kalau yang bawah akhirnya juga ngikuti yang air, jadi akan berbeda. Rays changing direction, maksudnya adalah cahaya itu akan mengubah arahnya. Ini, ya, kalau kita lihat di sini, karena di sini adalah udara, air itu udara, ya, yang di bawah itu adalah water, ya, maka terus kalau ini kita pengen melihat, berarti cahaya, if you wanna see the coin, actually principally the light from coin to our eyes, ya. Jadi kalau dari dalam ini kan lebih padat, ya, water itu kan lebih dense, more dense, ya, denser than apa itu air, ya, udara. Jadi water itu lebih apa namanya rapat daripada udara, sehingga the light ketika cahaya seperti ini, ya, dengan garis normal line, maka biasnya akan menjadi garis normal, ya. Jadi kalau di sini rapat ke udara yang lebih renggang, maka refracted rays of light-nya itu kemudian avoid the normal line. Jadi dia lebih menjauh. Kebalikannya, if the light from air to the water, ya, kalau cahayanya dari udara ke air, maka nanti refracted rays-nya atau cahaya hasil pembiasannya akan approximately with approaching to the normal line. Jadi dia akan mendekati garis normal. Oke. Okay. Okay, I think this is my explanation, ya, about light and then what's that reflection and then opaque and then transparent. Okay. Okay, thank you for your attention and terima kasih atas kehadirannya. I think enough for my explanation today and see you for the next meeting. It can be online or offline. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Terima kasih.
You're welcome. See you.